you can now connect attachments under pressure. Let's take a look at the HTE in action.
So now that we've shut the machine off, I'm going to go ahead and connect the attachment to the piece of equipment. What we have here on the lines are the OEM installed coupler and plug. So let's see what I can do here. As you can see, trying to connect the plug to the piece of equipment now while I have pressure built up behind the plug is impossible. So what happens now after not being able to connect the attachment to the piece of equipment is typically a service call. Service call will be going out to the customer's job site, wherever that may be, and they do not have the proper tools in order to crack the line to relieve the pressure behind the attachment. They will not be able to, as we just seen, connect the attachment to the piece of equipment. So as I'll show you now, this is typically how we could crack the line out in the field on a field service call. Now that we've relieved the pressure behind the line and tightened the plug back onto the hose, we will now be able to connect the attachment into the piece of equipment. Now that we've relieved the pressure on the attachment, we'll go ahead and connect it to the piece of equipment. So now I've taken off the OEM provided plug on the attachment and threaded on the Dixon HTE series connect under pressure flush face. So we've just been running the piece of equipment. We're getting ready to come in and attach our broom. Typically what we see out there in the field is that when the customer has a piece of equipment out there, if they're going from a broom to a bush hog, there's gonna be thermal expansion, pressure buildup in the feed and return line on the attachment. Yes, the piece of equipment does have a relief valve built in on the equipment side, but relieving the pressure behind the plug and the coupler on the attachment is what we're trying to overcome here. So let's see if I can connect this plug with pressure behind the line to the piece of equipment. Easy as that.
If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please contact us at DixonValve.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.